Greetings, sports fans. I'm Spencer Henderson with Franchise Sports, here to bring you a very special edition of the Blitz Analyst B-Series. Now, today we will be reviewing the 2012 FAMU football signing class and breaking down the commits who could be future Rattler stars stumping on the yard in Bradley Memorial Stadium for years to come. The FAMU Athletic Department implemented a savvy strategy of recruiting for the current class, resembling what the lead school from the Magic City, who shares their school colors, has done for years in building a fence and protecting the state of Miami. The Rattlers signed several players from local area football powers to replenish their talent, including two players from recent 2A state champion North Florida Christian High School here in Tallahassee. Now joining us in the studio is FS analyst and former FAMU and sports editor Roy Shepherd. Roy, tell us more about the local products that FAMU selected to join the football program.
Well, Spencer, they got two products who in particular stood out to me from the Tallahassee area, and that's Jamal Gay and Caleb Helms. Jamal Gay is a 6'3", 275-pound offensive lineman from Florida High School, and he's going to kind of be taking the role of what Brandon Curry kind of played to transfer from Marshall, and he's going to be solidifying that left tackle spot. You know, it was one of the areas that FAMU had to heavily recruit, so they went out and they got a big, solid product. He was first-team All-State, and it was rated as a three-star prospect by Rivals.com. Now, the other guy they got is Caleb Helms. He's a big, strong, 6'4", 255-pound defensive end, and he was one of the members of that North Florida Christian Championship team. Helms, he had 8 sacks and 5 tackles for a loss this season. So, you know, that kind of boosted his stock with Coach Taylor and the rest of his staff. And he also earned first-team all-area. So that should help bolster that lineup for the Rattlers as well.
Wow, that's going to be a big class coming up. In addition to players from schools nearby, FAMU mixed in signees from across the talent Latin gold mine, that is the state of Florida, to round out this year's class. One of the standouts from FAMU signing day would have to be the 6'2 wide receiver / safety, Neil Cunningham. The Orlando Sun Centennial actually reported his verbal commit a few days after he visited the Hill in early October 2011. While he was still garnering interest in programs like Western Michigan and Navy, Cunningham, rated a two-star recruit by Rivals.com, recorded 52 tackles and 6 interceptions this season for the Pompano Beach Tornadoes. After leading his high school to the 2A Region 4 Championship as team captain and earning first-team all-area honors, the weight room worker, according to his high school head coach, enrolled early to FAMU, joined the football team in January. Roy, when reviewing Cunningham on film, what jumps out about his potential at the next level of the SEC?
Well, when you look at him on film, the one thing that jumps out to you is his physical dominance at the high school level. I mean, I'm pretty sure that FAMU is recruiting him to be a safety. So the one thing that I looked at when I saw him on film was his strong tackling ability, his ability to finish tackles, drive through the person that he's tackling. So, you know, and another thing that stood out was that this kid graduated with a 3.7 GPA, and he also got a 1570 on the SAT. Now, the reason I'm, you know, most proud of it is because I know the kid. You know, I went to middle school with his sister, so I met him when he was in elementary school. He was always bigger for his age, but he's a very intelligent kid, and he should be one of the gems that FAMU signed this year, and then he should be helping the secondary that were trying to replace John Ojo.
Now, in addition to Comey, the Sunshine State, Florida A&M also plucked a pair of gems in two historically rich prep football states in Georgia and Pennsylvania. FAMU signed first-team All-State honoree Christopher Amos from Henry County High in McDonald, Georgia, as well as first-team All-Conference honoree Akil Blunt from Lansley High, Clayville, Pennsylvania. Roy, why are these commits so vital to this year's class, and what are some of the special tidbits about these young men?
Well, the funny thing is, Akil Blunt has championship and Hall of Fame DNA in him, as his father, Mel Blunt, is a championship defensive back from the Pittsburgh Steelers. He won first-team All-Conference and first-team All-State, and he broke the school record for sacks. Now, Blunt is a 6'3", 215-pound defensive end, and he may play linebacker for FAMU because he's a little small for a defensive end, but one thing about this kid is he never gives up on any plays. There's a reason behind him, you know, actually garnering that record for his school, and the school is quite prestigious as well in that category. But he relentlessly pursues the quarterback and the ball carrier all the time, and you know, he never quits on the play. So that's one of the things that should help. It brings energy to a team, and that's one of the things that he can provide. Now, Christopher Amos is probably the most talented overall prospect that this class has gotten. He's a 6'2", 180-pound strong safety who garnered 10 interceptions in his senior year. Now, he's just a natural ball hawk. He played wide receiver, but the physical nature of his game is, you know, is aggressive, and he will be a perfect fit in the secondary along with some of the other recruits that FAMU got. So, I mean, look for him to continue to trend and to help build on the success that FAMU secondary got last year when they got the school's second all-time record in interceptions for one season.
Yeah, man, it looks like the defense is going to be pretty decent this year. Okay, well, it sounds like fans of the Orange and Green have much to look forward to come spring football practice time. For more info on the 2012 FAMU football signing class, including what head coach Joe Taylor thinks about his commits and what they mean for the future of FAMU football program, make sure to head to FranchiseSportsOnline.net. With Roy Shepherd, this is Spencer Henderson with Franchise Sports.